Hello, my name is Deniz, and I live in a beautiful city called Burnaby. I grew up in China, therefore, I also have a Chinese name, which is Dahai, which means the ocean. My name always gives me this special bond with the environment and the nature itself, which is incredibly fascinating. After living in China for more than 15 years, I learned a lot about this awesome city called Zhongshan. It is crazy because it is a sister city of Burnaby. They share a lot of similarities as we can see. They're very committed to protecting the ocean, improving the air quality, and also preserving the marine life. As we can see, it is beautiful, isn't it? Just like my name.
Young individuals in Zhongshan are actively implementing sustainable living principles. Let's explore how they're making a difference and check it out.
Upon arriving in a new city, I make it a point to visit the old town of East City Center, as it provides a rich reflection of each city's cultural identity. Where I'm standing right now used to be the abandoned shipyard. Through citizens and designers' effort, they were successfully able to convert it into a prime example of industrial district regeneration projects on a global scale. But to truly understand its story, let's hear it from someone that has experienced it all and went through all the processes.
这公园有好多突破，以前中国的公园都是围墙围起来的，甚至还是买票的。那这个公园一开始设计就是把城市跟建筑融为一体，景观带动城市的发展。这里原来是个造船厂，你看也从铺地开始，包括旧的厂房、旧的机器，都代表了一种工业文明的一种语言，创造出新的美学观。
那个红色建筑是什么呢？
红色的建筑实际上是一个落口，吸取了中国传统的设计的一是理念，所以你会你看做过了一个桥，那么这个水啊，相当于是个海绵概念，把城市的雨水收集到这里。
就这一条。
然后形成一条溪流，这个溪流一个桥，但我这里的门呢就非常现代的设计了，很当代的一个盒子了。那么这个城市，山的这个城市，它又创造一种自己的一个感觉。 孙中山出生在这，所以他一直是思想先进，非常开放。另外，这个城市也是个华侨城市，所以他有世界眼光。对中山人呢，就是能够给世界同步。Zhongshan
is actually aiming to build more and more parks within the city, where they're creating a lush green landscape, just like the natural oxygen bar. Where there's another term also known as the ubiquitous green areas. Except the city center, I'm very keen to visit the rural area of Zhongshan to actually witness the innovative ecological practices embraced by the local residents.
I'm at Qixi Village, located in Zhongshan's southern region close to Wugui Mountain. The village is home to a group of nature-loving youngsters who pursue sustainable living. Together, they are creating a new and unique community.
Qixi Life Farm is the beating heart of this whole village. And what amazed me was that a small village like this has a population of over 250 registered residents. It attracts young entrepreneurs from all around the world, including graduates from well-known universities. But what really makes Qixi so appealing? Let's hear from Mr. Hao.
This is the 吉祥物.
吉祥物.
你知道这两个哪个是他们之间的老大吗？
是不是那个双下巴的？不是的，是这一只。 Hello，
是已经在农场生活了7年的那一只。那野金花现在还没有完全开放。
嗯。
它要等到下午六点左右的时候，它会展开。它会展开。哦。我们每天会采。它每天都可以。每天就采它刚刚要开的那一个。因为我们观察，野姜花基本上都是在下午六点才开始开放。嗯。那时候是刚刚好的一个点，然后到晚上它的吐香会比较好。那这一朵今天有可能就会开了。它的刚入口是甜的。嗯。但是后味是辣辣的，因为这就是因为它跟姜是同一个科属。
它还有一个更好听的名字，叫 Ginger Lily。That's
why it tastes like ginger.
姜百合。Ginger
Lily。可以试一下这个茶，是野姜花的味道。对，我有尝出来有一点点。对。啊，为什么您会偏偏选择中山齐溪呢？这里离城市并不太远，嗯，那这样就为我们做所谓的体验式的发展。 乡村旅游打下了一个很好的基础，也方便大家在这里生活。我们在这里做这个村子的一个原因，就是我们希望乡村振兴。那乡村振兴，在我们国家里面也提首先是要产业振兴。那我们在这里其实构建了一个多元化的产业模式，但是不光有农业，那我还有你还看到有很多的手工艺人。
对。
那
除了这之外，还有民宿。 非常强调这里是一个社区，我们搬到城市之后，很多人会觉得我在大城市里面有一种孤独感，没有人与人之间的链接。那这里我们是尝试创造一种更好的人与人之间的关系，所以其实这个社区成员都相互认识，甚至我们会有很多的社区活动。比方说我们会一起轮流做饭，轮流做饭是一个能够让大家幸福感更高的一件事情，就大家有相互之间的我们叫滋养。
What stood out to me the most during this trip is how the city is filled with lovely gardens. What's truly remarkable is the collaboration within the youth in creating more green homes. I'm very impressed by the shared environmental consciousness of both Zhongshan and Burnaby. I'm in Zhongshan. Stay tuned with China Matters.